Hello everyone. Today we are going to study about a script called Bank of India. The total study is based on the past performance of the script, which is subjected to market conditions in which all type of risks are involved. Here I like to announce that we are not promoting any individual stock or any company. We are making an educational recording and video. Purpose: knowledge sharing. That particular knowledge can be used for a long-term investment. A time horizon is 5 years, in which all type of risks are involved. I request you all to go through the disclaimer first. Let's proceed. This is the website of the script, Bank of India. You can go through, you can collect all the fundamental required details. For the technical part, I will be assisting you. Let's proceed. Bank of India. The face value of the script is 10 rupees. The 52 weeks high is 162.7, dated 31st of January 2018. The 52 weeks low is 73 rupees 20 paisa, dated 25th of October 2018. The closing price 94 rupees 85 paisa, dated 1st of February 2019. That's today. Let's check the historical data. The all time low is 8 rupees 80 paisa, dated 11th of October 2000. In a 10 years of span, the script has stretched 589 rupees, dated 7th of October 2010. Just imagine how many times it has multiplied. It has multiplied near about 66 to 67 times from the rate of 8 rupees 80 paisa. It had took 10 years of time, but it's a decent returns, near about 67 times approximate returns. The 52 weeks high and the low, which already we have seen, so nothing more to discuss. Let's proceed further. The shareholding pattern. The Bank of India, the promoters are holding 83.09%, public is holding 16.91%. The dividend provided by the script is up till 2015. After that, Bank of India has not provided any dividend. So let's proceed. This is the all-time graph. You can see that the volume is pretty decent, and the dividend provided by the script is up till 2015 only. After that, no dividend has been provided. The peak has been marked in the year 2010. After that, the script has come in a pattern of lower top and lower bottom. At present, it is hovering around an 94 rupees level. That's on 1st of February. For the better understanding and detailed study, let's check the 5 years graph. The 5 years graph, you can see here it has touched near about 345 levels. From there, the selling pressure has pushed the script down. You can see in the movement is a lower top and lower bottom pattern. The script has come down in a drastic manner. When the selling pressure has pushed the script down, it has come down in a pattern of lower top and lower bottom. It has reached here a 5 years low at this particular point in the year 2018 October. For the further detailed study, let's check the 2 years graph. Here you can see, as per the 2 years peak is 208 rupees approx. From there also the script has come down to a level here. You can see in the year 2018. Approximate a level of 75 to 73 rupees level. From there, the script has started moving in an upward direction. Let's proceed further. Here, I have taken a 2 years graph in a combination of RSI. Here you can see, when the script has come down and touched the green line over here, the natural buying has come in and it is driving the script in an upward direction. You can see in the graph also and the RSI also, when I stretched the 25 mark over here, where my cursor is. From there, the script has started moving upwards. For the detailed study and the better understanding, let's check the 1 year chart. Here, the 1 year chart. Here you can see the script has taken and support around here in the month of July once in the 75 rupees level. Here you can see it has taken a few times over here, exactly saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here the 7th time it has taken a support in the same level, and from there the script has started moving upward. The pattern now which we are seeing here is an higher top and higher bottom, where it is indicating an upward movement. Condition, it should not break the level of 73 or 75 below again. Let's proceed further. Here, I have taken a candlestick chart, where you can see the struggling point is near about 110 rupees level. From there, the script has been pushed down to the level of 85, and from there again it has moved up to a level of 104 today. The level where all the script has taken support is near about 75-73 level. Here you can see. From there, the script has moved upwards. The volume is also pretty decent. Let's proceed. Here you can see one double bottom or one W getting formed, which indicates a strong support over this particular point around 73 to 75 rupees level. From there, the script is trying to move in an upward direction. If it breaks the level of 105, 110 is indicated. Above 110, 118 is indicated. Let's move to the next level. Above 118 rupees level, 183 is indicated. Above 183, 216 is indicated. Let's proceed to the next level. At present, the script is hovering around this particular 75 rupees level to 110 rupees level. If it breaks the level of 216, it can move further upwards. Condition applied, it should not come down and break the level of 73 again. If it breaks the level of 73 and below, certainly the script is very weak. I repeat, below 73 rupees, the script is very weak. The Bank of India is very weak below 73 rupees level. It can take an fall downside. But at present there is no such indications in the graph. So let's proceed further. Here I have taken a 7 days data, according to which you can see 31st of January the script has triggered an high of 104.75, that is a resistance level at present. And the support level is 85 rupees 40 paisa. The volume is pretty decent. You can check yourself. Let's proceed to the 15 days data. According to the 15 days data also, 85.40 is the support level. 104.7 or 104.8 near about 105 rupees level acts as a resistance. Let's check the 1 month data. As per the 1 month data, the support level is same, that is 85.4, and the resistance has changed by 5 rupees, that is 110 rupees 15 paisa. You can see that is for the 1 month peak. Above 1 month, this peak when the script breaks, it can take a very big movement upside. That is above 110, the script can take an upward movement. Let's proceed to the 3 months data. According to the 3 months data, the support level is 76.1, resistance is 110 rupees only. Here, the point to be noted, below 75 or 73 rupees level, if the script Bank of India breaks, it is weak. Above 110, the script can take a very big movement upside. Let's check, as we are studying about the mob psychology or a crowd psychology, according to the volume and the deliverable volume, let's check what all the levels are indicated. Here we have assumed that Bank of India has taken support around 73.2, and these levels have been indicated. Above 95.16 or 95 rupees plus, the script can make a movement up to an 110 rupees level. Above 110, 131.8 is indicated. Above 131.8, 146.4 is indicated. Above 146.4, 219 is indicated. This total study is based on the volume traded and the total deliverable volume which has been traded in the National Stock Exchange and the different point of time. In a combination, we have arrived these all levels. This particular study, the mob psychology or a crowd psychology, is in a testing phase only. First, we have tested for S Bank. This is the second script where we are testing these particular levels. This is only for a study purpose. I request each and everyone to watch these particular levels. When it breaks, does the movement come or not? And I request each and everyone to only follow this for near about testing and 100 scripts, where we want to see what is the net result for the 100 script. I want to see the percentage of success on this particular crowd psychology or a mob psychology. What does the script give a rate of returns when it breaks the particular level? It can be used for finding the resistance level as well as the support level. The total study is based on the past performance of the scripts, which is subjected to market conditions in which all type of risks are involved. I like to announce, we are not promoting any individual script or any company. We are making an educational video, purpose knowledge sharing. That knowledge can be used for a long term purpose investments, I repeat, which can be used for a long term investment purpose where the time horizon is minimum 5 years. I like to thank each and everyone who has supported me till date and in coming future also. For the newcomers, I request them to press the bell button, click the subscribe button, so that you will be getting the latest information at the faster rate. I like to thank again each and everyone who is supporting me. Thank you very much.